And good morning, people of Memorial United Methodist Church. How is everyone doing today? Very, very nice. Well, let me say this. Welcome to Memorial United Methodist Church, the greatest Methodist church in the world. I'm so very, very happy that you are here today with us. My name is Vathanak Heang. It is my privilege and honor to be your pastor. Also, welcome people who are worshiping with us online, wherever you are. I pray that the Spirit of God will be with you, inspiring you, touching you, and moving you forward for that purpose that He wanted you to be. I want you to live like this full life, live life to the full. And friends, let me tell you this. I'm so very thankful that you decide to come to church on Sunday morning and many other days throughout the week as well. I pray that your effort to get up early, to come to church and to worship God will be paid off. I pray that after you leave this place today, you will be so energized. You will be so full of the Spirit of God that the grace of God will be with you as you leave this place, and that you will go out and live life that God wants you to be, to do and to become. That you will change this world one person at a time. Amen? Amen. Friends, are you filled with the Spirit? Well, you know, I want you to really soak it up. Every single part of this service today, let me remind you, we are here to worship our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen. We are not here not to just sing the song. We are not here not just to hear inspirational speech. We are not here not just to be with other people, to build your network. Well, those are a part of it too. But I pray that the fellowship that you have today, the prayer that you will do today, the songs that you will sing today, the sermon and the scripture that you will hear today will inspire you, will make you love Jesus even better, will give you that purpose of life, knowing why you were here. Friends, you are not here by accident. You are here by divine appointment. God has called you here for a specific purpose. So please, pay attention. God might be nudging you today. God might tap you on the shoulder today. God might want to speak to you today. What will that be? I pray that you will listen. Are you ready to worship? Yeah. All right, friends. I invite the acolytes to come down. They are coming down with the light of Christ. The candles represent the Spirit of God with us all today. I pray once again that the Spirit will touch you. That you are here today despite all the great things that you should have done, but you decided to come and worship our Lord Jesus Christ, that this purpose will be fulfilled today. That you will leave this place knowing that God is so pleased because of the act of worship that we all are doing together. Without further ado, I would like to invite our liturgist to help us in time of worship. Johan?
Good morning, everyone. I hope you guys are having a wonderful morning so far. And I'm just really blessed to be here again today, this morning. And now for the call of worship. I'll be the leader part, and you guys say the people part. May God be gracious to us and bless us. Let all people praise you, O Lord. God blesses us continually throughout all our lives.
Thanks be to God, your God, for eternal love and blessing. Amen.
Now please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine come and power and the glory forever. Amen. Now if you are able to, please continue to stand for today's scripture. Today's scripture is John chapter 14, verses 23 through 29. Jesus answered him, "Those who love me will keep my word, and my Father will love them, and will we and we will come to them and make our home with them. Whoever does not love me does not keep my word, and the word that you hear is not mine, but is from the Father who sent me. I have said these things to you while I'm still here, but the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your heart be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. You heard me say to you, I'm going away and I'm coming to you. If you love me, you will rejoice that I'm going to the Father, because the Father is greater than I. And now I have told you this before it occurs, so when it does occur, you may believe. The word of God for the people of God. You may be seated. And please give a big round of applause for Children's Moment.
How are you guys? Did you have a good week? So good to see you. You okay? All right. Big smiles that I can't see. You can hold on to him. You can hold on to him. Is anyone here afraid of the dark? Have you ever been afraid of the dark? What do you do when you're afraid of the dark? Get under the blankets. How about you, love? What do you do when you get afraid?
I turn on the lights.
Anybody else? Well, you know what I do when I'm afraid? First, I ask Jesus for comfort. And then, see my beautiful bear? He makes me feel better. You guys want to give him a hug? You can pass him down. It's okay. It's okay. I still hug him. He sleeps with me when I'm afraid. Well, anyways, look, doesn't he make you feel happy? He puts a happy smile on my face. When we are all afraid at times. There's things that scare us, huh? What makes you, some of you scared? Does lightning make you scared? Yeah, it's kind of scary, huh? That big noise. Can you think of some other ways how people comfort themselves when they're afraid? You know what I do sometimes? I eat ice cream. That always makes me feel better. So when Jesus told his disciples that he was going to go, he was going to return up to visit to be with his Father, the disciples were kind of afraid. They're like, "No, don't go. We need you here." And Jesus knew that his disciples were afraid, so he tried to comfort them. He says, I'm leaving you with a gift, the peace of mind and heart. I'm sorry, guys, I wasn't prepared today. Don't be troubled, and remember what I have told you. I am going away, but I will come back to you again. I will come and get you, so you will always be with me. These words sometimes, does that make you feel a little bit more comfortable knowing Jesus is there and he's going to take care of us? He's always in our heart, right? Yeah. So do you think you guys could say a prayer with me? Let's bow our heads. Father, we thank you for your Holy Spirit who guides us and calms our fears. We also thank you for the promise that one day we will be in heaven with Jesus. In his name we pray. Amen. Thanks, guys. Have a good week, okay?
Spirit of God, descend upon my heart.
pulses move. Stoop to my weakness, mighty as thou art, and make me love thee as thou art to love. I ask no dream, no prophet ecstasy, no
Don't you like the music? Give them a big round of applause. I love it, you know. They come together, they practice, they make sure we all are able to sing it nicely so that you will be uplifted by the meaning of the song. Don't you like it? It's amazing. Friends, before I preach, I usually tell a funny story, and this is about a pastor family. A pastor's wife is famous of packing food home, leftover, you know, put in the fridge and serve it home later. And now this dinner, pastor's wife took out the food prepared on the table, obviously the leftover, right? So the husband, you know, the pastor got into the table, stared at the food, not so much smiling, you know, obviously there's the leftover again. And then, you know, what can he say? He started eating. The wife said, "Babe, why don't you give the blessing to the food first? You know, say blessing before you eat." And the pastor said, "Honey, this food has been blessed 3 times already. One more time is not going to do any good." All right, friends, let me invite you to be in time of prayer. Wherever you are, I invite you to find your feet on the floor. Sit comfortably. Breathe deeply and slowly. Drop your shoulders from your chins. Relax all your facial muscles. Remember the love and the grace and the Spirit of God that has always been with us. Again, continue to breathe deeply and slowly. Think about somebody sitting next to you right now. Think about the blessing that God has been given to you so far. Now, it is time for you to go to God. You can completely listen to Him and allow Him to speak to you. Or you can go to Him with your prayer petition and prayer request or prayer of thanksgiving. Be with God. I'm going to give you a couple minutes in time of silent prayers, and then I offer a pastoral prayer. Please be in time of silent prayer. loving and merciful God. We are here today to worship you, Lord. We bow our heads. We surrender our lives to you. We ask that you are in control. We know that you are always with us. And so, Lord, inspire us. Keep reminding us that you are only a prayer away. We can always be with you in time of thick and thin. When we are happy or when we are sad, we can always celebrate with you or grieve with you. Thank you, Lord, for your amazing love. Thank you for your forgiveness for each and every one of us. We know we fall short for your glory, but your grace is enough for us. Your grace sustained us so far, Lord. And as we are here today, we give you praise. We give you thanks for all the good things that you have done in our lives, especially in the ministry of Memorial United Methodist Church. As we are growing together, as we are trying our best to find way to seek your kingdom, to serve the community, to be a part of this wonderful community that you have called us to be, to do, and to become, to be alongside with everybody in this wonderful community. Lord, we ask that you will continue to inspire us, to send us out, to give us that power and that energy that we need so that we can move forward with grace, with thanksgiving, knowing you are always walking alongside with us. And Lord, give us the wisdom. Give us the information that we need. Give us that inspiration that we need, Lord. And so, may the word of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable to your sight, because you are our rock and you are our Redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Friends, in life, we are looking for this American dream, right? Everybody, every one of us, right? We are moving forward. We're trying to find, you know, trying to balance our happiness and sometimes our struggles that we are going through. We want shelter for our children, for our family. We want income that can support our family. We want laughter and vacation for our family. We want vehicles that can take us from one place to another. We want social gatherings, friends that we can always talk to and party with, right? All these good things that we are looking for. We want the community that we can be a part of so we can go and serve. That makes our life a lot more meaningful, because it's not all about me, me, me. But God has called us to go out and live the love that God has given to us. The sacrificial love. The sacrificial love that we want to be a part of, that we want to participate. Because again, that gives us the morale, the purpose, that gives us the spirit, right? To go out and do something. Woo, when I am a part of, you know, the Rotary Club, go clean a park somewhere with my friends. Oh man, that makes my spirit so much better. When I'm with my community, my wonderful church here, you know, cleaning the church or cut down weeds or paint the building, you know, that gives us a lot of happiness. But then once again, life is not always that easy. And sometimes life can be so troubling, so difficult, and we're like, how am I going to pass through this? It is so hard. It is so difficult. I don't think I can move on anymore. And I'm very happy, very pleased with today's passage. Today's passage is for the sixth Sunday after Easter. It is one Sunday before the Ascension Sunday. It is the time when Jesus coming to his disciples and reminding them that, hey, my time is up. I'm going to be with the Father to prepare a place for you. But I am always with you. The first word that you just listened today from John chapter 14, verse 23, say, whoever loves me will keep my word. Thy word is the lamp unto my feet and the light unto my path. Beautiful, friends. How many of you know that the Word of God is so important? It's the instruction for you to move on, to live, to live by, to obey, and to do the Word of God, right? The book of Matthew say what? Men shall not live by bread alone, because you need to butter it up, right? I mean, you know, but you also live by the Word of God. The Word of God is the lamp unto your feet. The Word of God is the light unto your path. Somebody give that Bible, right? Bible, I say, Bible stands for basic instruction before leaving earth. That's not a real acronym of it, but I think that sounds really good. You know, as we are living this world, as we are trying to live our life to the full, we use the instruction, the Bible, the Word of God, as the instruction for us to live before we leave this temporary place. What is the Word of God for you, friends? You know, to Abraham, God said this, go and you will be blessed. Your name will be great. You will start all nations, and your blessing will pour out to so many others. That's the Word of God for Abraham. For Joseph, God came to Joseph in a dream and said, look, your future will be great. You will be the prince. You will be taking care of the world. You will feed the famine world. You are amazing. And he was living up to it. What is the Word of God for you? Think about it. When you spend time with God in time of prayer, or maybe Bible study, or maybe your devotion time, or maybe when you are reading the Bible at your own comfortable time, what does God speak to you? What is God inspiring you to do, to be, and to become? What is it? You're going to be the greatest grandparent in the world. You're going to be the greatest member of Memorial United Methodist Church, the greatest Methodist church in the world. You're going to be the great pastor in the near future. What is it? What is God calling you? What is the Word of God for you right now? And how do you get the strength, the energy to fulfill the mission, the Word of God in you? You know, the Word of God for you is not for you just to listen, but to also obey. Right? I want you to not just only the listener of the word, but the doer of the word as well. Right? We want to do the word. We want to listen to the word and put it in practice. Look at Joseph. Look at Joseph. This guy, God spoke to him and God said, hey, look, your brothers will harvest all these harvests and they will come and bow before you. And guess what? Many other nations will also bow before you. Wow, that's a big challenge for Joseph himself. And he was doing everything possible to make the dream come true. And you heard the story of Joseph. There's a lot of struggle for Joseph to make that dream come true. What happened to Joseph? Joseph told his dream to his brothers, and his brothers was jealous, and his brothers was sold him to slavery. Even when he was in slavery, when he was a slave, he was a servant, he didn't give up the Word of God for himself. He thrived to be the best so that he would learn every possible skills he knows that he wanted to become the person that God called him to be. When he was serving with a great minister of a king, Potiphar, he was serving Potiphar so well that he became the manager of the household. But then while he was in this top position, he faced another challenge. Potiphar's wife was trying to, you know, have intimate relationship with him. Joseph was trying to escape, but he could not escape from the trap of his wife, or Potiphar's wife, and he eventually ended up in jail. See how life does not really go the way you should be, right? Sometimes you say success is moving from one point A to point B, like a straight line, you know, like you're looking at the stock market exchange, you know, go boop, right? But really, success does not happen like that, right? You are here right now, and success go like, you know, it just go up and down, left and right, you know, north and south. And Joseph was going through that hard time too. Now he is in prison. But did he give up the plan that God wanted him to be and to do? No, he didn't give up. He know what God has called him to do, to be, and to become. He didn't give up. He was still performing his best, and eventually he could become the person to the cupbearer of the king, talk to the king. The king understood his skills, his talent, and eventually Joseph became the prince of Egypt. He was the second person in command after the king itself. And at the end of the story, Joseph was the one who managed to save the region because of his management skills, that he could store up the food to help when that region was in famine. What God has spoken to you? What is the word of God for you? How are you working toward it? And when you are going through hard time, when you are struggling, how do you deal with it? Because Jesus understands that these 12 disciples who were following Jesus, as faithful as they would face troubles, challenges, thousands of challenges, very difficult challenges. People were trying to trip them up. And then Jesus said this, "The advocate, the Holy Spirit, will teach you everything." Do you see this? Wow, the advocate, the Holy Spirit, will teach you everything. Friends, let me tell you this. Sometimes when I was doing this sermon, I was like, how am I going to explain the Holy Spirit working, walking alongside, be with my people all the time? And guess what? I don't have to explain that, because you know what it means. You experience yourself. Whenever I visit you, whenever I talk to you, whenever I talk to you about your spiritual life, you know it. I just only have to give you a couple minutes to think about the incident, the time, the situation when you know the Spirit of God was with you, that you could move over obstacles because not of your own understanding, not because of your own might, not because of your own ability, but by the miracle of God alone. The Spirit of God has been always with you, has been so good to you. Friends, that's amazing. Let's give God a big round of applause. The Spirit of God is always with you, has always walking alongside with you. You know, sometimes we kind of forget him, you know. Sometimes we kind of like, put the matters onto our own shoulder. We try to want to share, to show the world that you are mighty and powerful. Yeah, I mean, if you can lift it up, lift that burden up by yourself, you know, credit to you. But there are some times when you're like, man, without the Spirit of God, it's just impossible. I told you a story of a single mom who escaped the domestic violence. And then she was in trouble. She was in a hard time. She could not see how her life would be better. But then, the Spirit of God was with her through the dark night, through the night full of fog, through the time that she had to drive over her beat up van, escaping the domestic violence to try to find a place that God wants her to be. And God's Spirit has always been with her along the way. And right now, she has a home, she has a job, she has an income, she has a school to go to. Her children now find schools, and one of her kid became 1 week in school, she received the certificate of Student of the Week honor. I mean, yeah, come on, that the Spirit of God walking alongside, you know? And when I think about this, friend, this cannot happen without this community of faith that are working together alongside, bearing each other a burden, help each other to carry up whatever obstacle it is, because we are in this together. We are the brothers and sisters in Christ. And this is the business that we, our church is doing. This is the business, to transform life, to make disciples of Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world. And we do this with one person at a time. Can I hear an amen for that? Amen. I know it's hard, but the Spirit of God is always with you. And Jesus said this, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you." Friends, when you experience the Spirit of God, you will experience His peace. His peace is different from everything else, friends. When you allow yourself to be rooted in the Word of God, when you allow yourself to be reminded by the instruction, by the Word of God, you will experience that peace. Even though sometimes the turbulent might look like the situation that you are in. But that peace, friends, whatever it is calmer than everything else, right? That peace of when you decide to leave a full-time job to become a minister. That peace, you need that peace for you to really have that courage. The courage of leaving a secure benefit, you know, good income job to just say, God has called me. The Word of God is with me to go out and share the gospel of Jesus Christ to the world. And therefore, I'm going to leave my full-time appointment, my full-time job to become a minister. Think about that peace, friends. The peace of like when you are now serving in a wonderful church, you know, your wife is also working, you have a wonderful family, the house is nice, and then you hear a call from Bishop saying, you are moving to Clovis. You know, you need that peace of God to be able to say, yes, Bishop, I know I'm going to uproot my wife, I'm going to uproot my family. We're gonna go all together. I don't know where Clovis is actually, you know, but you know. But God gave you that peace of like, yeah, let's go. Because the word, the peace that God gives, I do not give to you as the world give. See, the peace of God is not the world peace. You know, when I told my Rotary Club friends in Santa Clara that I'm moving to Clovis, they were like, why? You know where Clovis is, right? You know what the weather like out there, right? I said, no. Yeah, you will know. It's closer to hell out there. It's very, very hot. You know, and they're like, well, why are you moving? You're doing good here. Your wife is working and everything. I mean, wow, it must take a lot of gut for you to move. You know what I'm saying? The peace that God gives to me is not the same peace that the world will give to me. The world won't understand that. What? What is going on? What? In the Methodist church, you just got moved just like that? Like somebody up there give you a call and say you're moving? Like, that's not going to work. That's not going to work in my family, you know? In your family, can you imagine? But again, the peace that God gives, it's not the same as the peace that the world would give, right? Because when you are serving God, sometimes you're like, well, do I have to really travel the 3 hours to do that? No, that does not make sense. But when you experience the peace of God, that makes a lot of sense. Because you know why God is calling you to do that. Because you know exactly why. Then, friends, with all that security, with all that assurance, the Spirit of God with you, the peace of God with you, you were still challenging. You will still face the challenges. Do not let your heart be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. See, I love how Jesus understands that situation, you know, like he knows it. Oh, you know, your life is going to be up and down. You will face all these things. Yeah, I know you will pray. I know you will study. I know you will talk to your minister. I know you will have time counseling. But still though, you will face problem. Your heart will be in trouble. But hey, remember what I tell you? No, don't let your heart be troubled. and do not let them be afraid. And even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storm of this life, I won't turn back. I know you are near, and I will fear no evil, for my God is within me. And if my God is within me, whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Singing, oh no, you never let go, through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, you never let go, through the high and through the low. Oh no, you never let go, Lord, you never let go of me. Man, that song is so good. Do you like it? Come on. I try my best. I know I'm not American Idols, but I know that song means a lot to you. You know what I'm talking about? Oh no, God would never let go. Just amazing, friends. Let me remind you this. When life is going through time of troubles, God is always with you. The Spirit of God is there, ready to lift you up, will help you to soar and to fly like the eagle in the book of Isaiah. The book of Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. Let's read it with me. 1, 2, 3. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagle. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. You shall wait upon the Lord. The Lord is always with you, friend. Give him a big round of applause. God is amazing. God is awesome. God will always be with you and lift you up wherever you are. Think about it. Listen. The Word of God. What is it? Never give up on it. Sometimes it is difficult. Sometimes it is challenging. But God will never let go. God will always be on your side. Friend, Jesus called his disciples to come together to this one upper room. That is right before he was crucified. He wanted to give them such good example of what it means to live together as the body of Christ. Before the dinner start, Jesus took the bread and he broke it and he gave thanks to God and gave it to the disciples and said, take and eat. This is my body broken for you. Friends, when you come in, you were given the communion element. In our church, everybody is welcome to receive the communion. Everybody is allowed that experience to be with the divine. As you are opening the first layer of the communion element, you will find the wafer. When you eat the wafer, remember, the body of Christ broken for you. When Jesus was wounded on the cross, it's all for you, so that you all are healed, so that you all remember the sacrificial love that Christ has given to you. After the dinner, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks to God, gave it to disciples, and tell them that to drink from this cup. This is the cup of the new covenant poured out for you and for many. Drink from this cup for the forgiveness of your sin. And do this as often as you can in remembrance of me. When you drink from the cup, friends, remember the blood of Christ has been shed for you. You don't have to go to church with animals to sacrifice anymore. You come to church knowing that Jesus is the Lamb of God. Jesus is the sacrificial Lamb of God. The blood of Christ has made you pure. The blood of Christ has cleansed you. The blood of Christ has made you as white as snow. Friends, I invite the music team to come up. They will lead us into a time of singing today. And as they are singing this song, I pray that you will sing with them. Look at the lyrics. Allow the lyric to speak to you. If you want, you can come to the communion rail and kneel down and pray. I promise you, God is speaking to you right now. Or you can go to the candlelight station over there in that corner. Light a candle representing the light of Christ shining wherever there is darkness. Friends, I pray that the music will speak to you right now. Friends, I pray that the service today has been touching you, that you remember the Word of God is with you, and the Word of God is inviting you to move, to do, to be the doer of the Word of God. And now, friends, I invite you to give, to support the ministry of our church. We cannot do all these things without your support. As you probably have known, our youth building that we've been renovating is almost finished. On Tuesday, the guy come to paint, and after we paint it, it should be a good time for us to move in. It's going to be nice. It's a great place for our youth to be able to come and speak and share their love and talk about their faith safely in this place. And thank you once again for your love and your support. You can give to our church by writing a check to Memorial United Methodist Church, or you can give online. Aim your camera, your smartphone camera, onto the QR code that you can find in the bulletin. Or friends on worshiping with us online, you can do the same. Go to our United Methodist, Memorial United Methodist website. You can donate online as well. Friends, may the Spirit of God bless the hand that can give and that cannot give today. And as you are so generous, I'm so very thankful. Now, I invite you to join with me to say the dedication prayer with me. Let the light of God's eternal love flood into your hearts this day. Feel the healing presence of God in your lives. Accept God's love and hope for you. This is the gift freely given for you by Jesus Christ, God's risen Son, our Lord. Amen. Please stand for doxology.
Praise God and from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise God above the heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Now, our closing hymn is, Let There Be Peace on Earth.
You know this one. Let's sing it loud.
Friends, before I do the benediction, please remember that I love you, Diane's loves you, Don loves you, Ron loves you, Rich loves you, Jesus loves you, and there's nothing you can do about it. Amen? God is good. And all the time, friends, when you leave this place, I pray that the Spirit of God will be with you wherever you are. Please remember that you are given the strength and the energy from the Almighty. That your purpose in life is to go out and make disciples of Christ for the transformation of the world. That you will go out and be that agent of love. And let love be. And let love speak from you to others. That your thought, your actions, and your words will be filled with the love of Christ. Because Christ first loved you, and therefore you will go and bring peace of Christ to the world. So the world will also experience the peace of God. So go, friends. May the Spirit of God be with you wherever you are. Amen.